Greetings all, the Devious Monkey here. It's just a tad more relaxed today. Why, you say? I'm gonna tell you. Continuing the saga of shipping and the nightmare that I've been going through. Not really a nightmare, it's just a pain in the ass. So yesterday, of course, I complained that I wasn't getting my freaking company laptop that was shipped to me last Thursday and should have been here on Friday. So finally, it was 10 to 7. The UPS store closes at 7, and I thought to myself, I'm not getting that laptop today. It's just not happening. I was waiting for after 7 so that I could go back on the FedEx site and request that it be held at their facility. I finished up here in the office. I walked downstairs, looked at my wife, and I said, well, so much for getting my freaking laptop now that it's, 7 o'clock. I can't make this up. I swear to Zeus. As soon as I got done saying that, boom, I got a text. I looked at it. It said the laptop was delivered. Okay. So knowing that there was no way that I could get from here to the UPS store in under 10 minutes, and I didn't want to be that guy that walked in at the, a minute before they closed. So I thought, I can't do anything with it tonight anyways. I'll just go first thing in the morning. Sure enough, I got up early this morning, and I know that they opened at 9, and even before 9, they sent me notification that I got a package, which was the laptop. So I thought, okay, I'm not even gonna eat breakfast or anything. I'm just gonna go get it right now. That way I have it and I can start working on it before my calls started at 10, because I had calls from 10 to 12 that I had to make. So I got it and they literally just sent me a laptop. There was no power cord, nothing, just the replacement laptop. Fine. Turned it on and immediately started doing all of the Windows updates and all that crap. And I just had those going on in the background while I was doing my calls. In the meantime, one of the IT people reached out to me and said, did you get it yet? And I said, actually, I did, but I have calls from 10 to 12. I'll get a hold of you after I'm done with those calls and you can get on there and do what you got to do. I worked with a couple different people today. They got all the software on there. I got everything hooked up to be able to print and to scan and do all that lovely stuff that I have to do for my job again. And I think it's pretty much done. There's a couple of things after I got off the line with the last guy. I forgot them. Now, even though I made a Word document showing everything, I did forget those two things on there. And as I was going through it, I was like, oh crap, I forgot to do that. So I actually figured one of them out on my own while I was waiting for him to get back to me. And then the second thing he couldn't do. So he had to reach out to somebody else and that person's gone for the day. So saga continues tomorrow. But it is a very low on the totem pole thing, which is why I didn't remember in the first place. But that's all taken care of. I got my new company laptop. It's set up. It hasn't shut off on its own yet. I'm still keeping the old one just in case I forgot something else and I got to go back and look at it. But I think I'm good to go. So yes, finally, I think I have a laptop for my company that's working and set up properly. That's done and over with. Now, the other thing, and this is the stuff that threw me for a loop. Well, okay, I got my handle. Because I had a handle for this run and gun setup, or for whatever, but the connection point went into the hot shoe. And I mean, I bought that thing, that was like one of the first handles I ever bought. It was several cameras ago, years ago, and I didn't like it because it bothers me to put something into the hot shoe like that, and when you're pulling at the top like this, and you're kind of moving it and doing this and doing that and moving it around, I just felt like that was gonna damage the hot shoe, which bothered me. So the other day I was just like, you know what, I'm just gonna get one of these things, and this, you're never gonna be able to see it, but it has the RE connector point there that fits on the cage. And because the cage has the holes more towards the front, how can I angle this? More towards the front instead of way back here on the hot shoe. It also moves the handle forward, which allows me to put the screen up and not bash it into the back of the handle if I were to turn the handle around and all that kind of stuff. So I can still hold it facing me and I can see, that I'm in the frame or not. And that's cool. But all right, so I'm finally done. I got that handle. And I don't know that I was expecting it today or not expecting it today, but I got it today, so all is well. The other thing that I was bitching and moaning about was this mask, this leaf mask. that they never updated anything on, that they still haven't responded to on any of my questions, and I wasn't supposed to get this until the end of this week. I got another package delivery notification today, and this was after I had gone this morning and got the laptop. And I thought, oh, it must be the handle. And I did the search on it, and it was like out for delivery. And I was like, well, what else did I buy? What did I forget about? And I went through all of the things that I'm tracking currently. And of course, there's the one thing that's from AliExpress that's not coming until next month. Definitely wasn't expecting that. And then I had to buy a couple other things for myself that I wasn't expecting until the end of the week either. So I looked, and it showed me that I got this mask. And I'm like, what the hell? No update since February 26th. Then I get tracking to show that it's not supposed to be here until Friday, and it shows up today. Okay, I'll take that. I'll take that as a win. This is the mask. As you can see, it's clear. It has the little filter at the bottom. It has these things on the side, the vents on the side that I put those N95 filters into, and I switched these so instead of it going around the back of my melon, it goes over my ears. Okay, now, why do I love this mask so much already? When you put this thing on, and it has like this really cool wire in here, not some flimsy like paperclip wire. It has this nice wire that goes in there. All right, I'll take it off. That conforms it exactly to your face. But that's not why I love it. I guess it helps. The reason I love this mask so much and why I wish I had this a year ago is because when you put this thing on your face, air does not escape, all right? It does not fog my glasses. I've tried it with, I have three pairs of glasses laying around the house for various things. I'm excessive, you know that. All right, so it doesn't fog any of them. And especially the one pair of Ray-Bans, the newer set. Let me just show you. Out of all of the glasses that I have, these are by far the worst when it comes to fogging. There's not a mask in existence that I have used over the past year that these did not fog instantly. The minute I put them on and I put the mask on, boom, it's fogging from the first breath. Now, when I put this on, oh, no fog. Doesn't matter what I do. I wore this thing for like an hour today just to test it. I tried it with three different pairs of glasses and with my sunglasses, my Ray-Ban sunglasses, and they don't fog. Ah, it's all I've asked for. It's all I've asked for since this pandemic bullshit started, that I could have a mask that didn't fog my glasses, because I have old ass, broke dick eyes, and I can't see shit close up. So I have to wear these things. Now, I don't wear them when I'm on film, because then you get all these reflections and everything. But I do have to wear them. So that's why I have so many pairs, because I have this pair, which stays in here in the office slash studio. So when I have to do anything close up, I have to put those on. So when I'm like, even when I'm checking the lights and the status and the, you know, the temperature and this, that, and the other thing, when I have to have those on. I cannot see close up. That's from being old. This pair is the one that has the transition in them with the polarization, and because when these get really dark, if I'm looking at my screens on my cameras, I can't see them, which then prompted me with the last time that I was able to use my insurance to get glasses, which was just at the beginning of January. That's why I ended up getting the prescription Ray-Ban sunglasses, so that I could see out and about in the sunshine when I'm filming. But having to have glasses on almost constantly, having a mask on sucks. Because no matter what, it fogs. Fogs the lenses, and you know, no matter how much I pushed it down and shoved it and, you know, moved it around my face, they just fogged. This doesn't fog. Now, I'm gonna do a full review on this mask. Not today. I just wanted to let you know I got it, because I've been bitching and moaning about it, and why I love it already. So far, I mean, unless it completely disintegrates after like a couple of days, which I don't think is gonna happen, I already love it. And I'm good to go. I don't really give a shit that you can see my mouth when I'm talking. I don't give a crap about any of that. I don't care that it has super silicone, that it's anti-fog inside the mask, or any of that stuff. The only thing that I care about is that I can put that damn thing on and wear my glasses and sunglasses and not have them fog up instantly. All that being said, I'm taking today as a total win. I got up early, my sleep app showed that for the third day in a row, I got plenty of deep sleep, I felt good, I had my meetings today that went well, I got the laptop, it's all set up, I got my handle, good to go there, and I got my new mask, and it's perfect. It's exactly what I had hoped every mask that I bought ever did. So it's a win. Today's a win. See, I can be positive. Shit can go well. And it normally does. But you wouldn't watch me if I was all happy all the time. I know you like to hear me bitch and moan, right? Okay, that's really all I got for you. I just wanted to update you because I know that yesterday I was just like out of my mind about how pissed off I was about not getting that laptop and everything. So, okay, it's a win. That's all I got for you. So if you have any comments, leave them down below. I will, again, do a review on this mask, if anyone gives a shit, and give you my thoughts on how it works and blah, 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 and all that kind of stuff. Now that I've got my good handle, I'm going to be out and about, and I'll probably just leave this set up this way. I will be out and about filming. It was another beautiful day in Zamunda. Tomorrow's going to be even warmer, so I'm going to go play, especially after sitting inside all day dicking around with IT on that computer. So that's it. That's all I got for you today. Leave a comment down below. Like, subscribe, and all that shit. And remember, kids, forward and up.